and we see the Hawks ready to get to work. And thanks for tuning in to the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you're enjoying your Friday afternoon. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. Doris Burke will be reporting from the sideline. We're in the Phillips Arena. The Hawks here in Atlanta playing before their hometown crowd. Now a chance to check out tonight's starting lineups. And guys, checking out Michael Conley. What can we see here, you think?
You know, we've seen a lot of change in terms of what Mike Conley can do each year on the floor. He started out, didn't really have much of a jump shot, really improved in that area. Now he's playing with so much confidence that no matter what the circumstance during the game, he believes he can get the job done.
And one of the biggest ways he's made contributions to his team is by taking the ball away from the opponents. I mean, he's excellent with anticipation and quickness and tenacity, particularly at the point of attack. Hawks were pretty solid against the Western Conference, splitting the 30 games they played, 15 and 15. And if you do that against the West, when you're an Eastern Conference team, usually you're going to make the playoffs, and the Hawks did as a sixth seed.
Now here is Conley, feeds to Gasol. From down in the low post, it goes. And so it's Atlanta with it. And for the Hawks against the West, as Clark, you were talking about earlier, 15 and 15. It might sound ho-hum, but Steve was actually the fourth best record against the West of all teams in the East.
Well, look, the West, you know, the more dominant conference. I think 15 and 15 is a pretty solid record for Atlanta. So they had a good showing last year against the West.
That's good. Prince has got his first points of the game. And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. Teague against Conley. Teague, the pass to Williams. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Hawks on D. Outside Conley. Here's Prince. Banked in off the glass. Prince has got his second bucket of the game to go.
That was some skill there. Nice use of the bounce pass.
It's Williams with the drive. Plenty of space, and it's good from Corbin.
Oh, they are locked and loaded early. 3 for 3.
Conley kicks to Allen. He feeds it to Randolph. Lays it up and banks it in.
And they're on fire. They've made 4 straight shots to get this thing going.
Millsap a screen on Conley. Off the pick. And it's slammed in by two.
Basketball 101, guys. I mean, elementary. Use the screen to free yourself and then take it straight to the rack.
Yeah, very nice set play for it.
Well, that's using your head and using your body.
And the replay, of course, presented by Kia. What a play. Here is Conley following the bucket by the Hawks. And he misses his first shot of the game. Horford attacking, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Grizzlies will take it.
Mike Conley, the starting point guard in Memphis pretty much his whole career. I'm sure he would agree that last season was probably his best yet.
The Grizzlies have gone 4 of 5 from the field so far. Conley sets a screen for Gasol. There's the bucket. Good.
Those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten in the first half here.
And I think they should really continue to work it down low, Clark. That's really going to free up the rest of their offense.
And for Conley last season, an uptick in three-pointer and free throws attempted. Very interesting combination of numbers there.
Well, and for a perimeter player, a lot of times that can be the key to offensive efficiency, because when you can shoot from the three-point line, it makes you even quicker than you already are. Defenses have to attack and chase you off that line, and now you can get into the paint and make other plays happen.
Goes up to the stripe. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot.
And they have to mix it up defensively. That was just too easy.
For Atlanta, they've gotten all 5 of their shots to go down in the first quarter. Terrific start. Here's Millsap. And the layup's good off the glass.
I'll tell you what, the post play has been rock solid right off the bat.
Well, that's the key to basketball. Get the ball inside, into the paint, either with a pass or with penetration.
A nice shot by Gasol.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark, just piling up points in the paint.
Now here's Millsap. Williams with the ball. Horford dishes to Korver. Six to shoot. Teague the pass to Horford. That's good, and so Teague with the assist. Here's Conley. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Kicks it out to Allen. Conley into the lane. The feed to Randolph. And that is good. Randolph's got 6 points.
Nice pass there to set that bucket up.
Yeah, guys, and that's 10 of their last 12 points now coming off of assists.
Here's the lob to the hoop, and it's slammed in by Millsap.
Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered it down.
And that's the play we're going to remember when this game is all said and done.
Grizzlies have gone an incredible 8 of 9 from the field. The shot's good from Randolph.
Boy, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. Excellent.
Yeah, that's...
And so it's Atlanta with it. 1:53 left to play in the first quarter.
Well, Mike Budenholzer, you know, the new coach of the Hawks, spent 19 years with the San Antonio Spurs, including 17 as an assistant. Well, you couldn't ask for a better teaching ground than that.
The Grizzlies trail by 3. Randolph sets a screen for Conley. Throws it up high, and it's Davis with the jam.
What a beautiful pass to set that one up.
The pass might have been pretty, but the finish, I thought, Clark, angry.
That's a heck of a combination. Pretty pass and an angry punch.
I would call it an irate finish either.
Back to Budenholzer, who's with the Spurs for 19 years. Steve, the Spurs, the winningest team in pro sports over the last 15 years.
Yeah, I'm glad that Budenholzer has finally gotten his chance. I played for him for 4 seasons. He's a guy who loves the game. He's very dedicated, hardworking, and has learned from probably the best coach in the NBA during his time in San Antonio. And that's 10 straight points in the paint. I mean, defensively, the wind has just been knocked out of their sails.
Need to get more bodies committed down low.
Here's Schroeder. Here's Jenkins. Lee Bass was put in just the right spot.
Everybody on the floor is hot. Incredible stuff here in the early stages.
Tell you what, both teams playing downhill. Who's going to blink first?
Conley kicks to Bayless. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got 5 assists in the game.
Well, it's definitely been a shootout. But the team that can start playing some defense might have an edge.
Here's Schroeder. Millsap misses. Now here's Conley, the fast break opportunity. Here's Randolph, and he misses the go-ahead basket. Now Jenkins. Pass to Schroeder. He sinks the 11-footer. And the Hawks lead by 3. Well, it's been a high-scoring competitive game through the first quarter of play. Hawks lead by 3. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. And we got a close game here as we get back to the second quarter. What do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Hawks?
Boy, the 3-point shot has really been dropping for him.
Scoring inside.
So the Grizzlies 5 right now. Quincy Pondexter out there with Jared Bayless. Then there's Tayshaun Prince. And there's Davis. And it's Gasol with the 5 down low. And he gets it to go. Horford's got the opening basket here in the second quarter for the Hawks.
The mid-range jumper becomes a pretty high percentage shot for him when he has that kind of space.
Here is Bayless, defended by Schroeder.
Good. That is not enough coverage. Got to do better than that defensively. Basically, no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there.
Right wing. Let's it fly from 18. Grand. Good. Grand's got his first basket. Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter.
lot of what Memphis has done to build its team would have to be considered taking the undervalued approach. You look at guys like Zebo, Marc Gasol, and most recently Jared Bayless. Those were good players that really have found a nice home in Memphis.
Here's Schroeder following the score by Tayshaun Prince. And the shot's good from Schroeder. Schroeder's got six.
Late reaction from the defense. And he's always going to make good on that.
Here's Davis. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off. Stupendous rush to the rim and a mighty slam on the end of it.
But through the teeth of some pretty soft D, I can't help but say that.
Well, let's see how that impacts things here. Because those kinds of plays sometimes can be game changers on both sides.
Jenkins, another three for Atlanta. Ed Clark just talking about Memphis. They really have taken a group of players that were thought to be non-impact roster spots, and Steve, they've turned things around with them.
It kind of comes across in the way the entire team plays. It's a blue-collar group, Kevin. Some cast-offs, guys with a chip on their shoulder, but they've got a toughness and an edge about them. And I think it's really helped this team create its identity.
Schroeder passes to Jenkins. He dishes it to Carroll. Drills it from outside. Carroll's got 6 points.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all alone for that shot. It was a warm-up jump.
And stolen by Horford. And Jenkins kicks to Carroll. Passes to Schroeder. That's good. Schroeder's got 4 points now in the quarter. Number two, around 3 minutes gone by. So timeout called here. The first for Memphis.
A soft spot in this defense. Maybe making those early adjustments will give them time to judge their effectiveness by halftime. We'll soon find out, Kevin.
All right, Doris. Here is Bayless. And it's three. The shot is off. The Grizzlies trail by eight. Here's Pondexter. Another shot, and Allen with the layup.
That rebound and the follow kind of typify what he's all about. Just gritty, determined play.
Dishes to Korver. Shoots the three. Rebound by Pondexter.
Boy, from my angle, it looked like it was in the bottom of the net. Looked good from here.
Yeah, I thought so too, Clark.
Tries to save it. Out of bounds, Atlanta takes possession. Zach Randolph is checked in for Quincy Pondexter. Atlanta leading by six. It's Williams with the drive, and he banks in the layup. Williams has got five. And so here's Memphis.
Well, Lewis Williams has two things working for him on the offensive end. First, he is lightning fast, and secondly, he shoots the ball so well that he's able to use a great pump fake and really keeps defenders guessing.
And Gasol gets it to go.
Michael Conley with excellent vision on that pass.
Here's Williams, and it's thrown down hard with both hands. Well, Clark, a clear lane to the basket and the emphatic jam.
And that is outstanding attacking basketball.
Well, he had no choice but to take that one to the bucket.
Going back to Williams, more turnover prone last season than we're used to seeing.
Yeah, that's normally a strength of his, Kevin. High volume offense without turning it over. Of course, he changed teams, so perhaps adjusting to the new system made him a little more mistake prone. He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback right here.
Here's the lob to the hoop, and it's slammed in by Milson.
Phenomenal alley-oop slam right there.
They're taking advantage, Clark, of a team that looks lost out there.
Yeah, this is threatening to get kind of ugly out here.
The Grizzlies trail by eight. Here's Conley, and it's Memphis with another. Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
The Hawks made the playoffs again, but ended up losing in the first round to the Pacers in six games. Drop.
The Hawks leading by six. Rowing for the Hawks, it's been six consecutive seasons with basically this group. Certainly Joe Johnson left as a free agent to Brooklyn. But Steve, they have yet to get past the second round in any of those playoff runs.
I think that's why they decided to part ways with Josh Smith and originally with Joe Johnson 2 seasons ago, just to make that next step, to start fresh. And they may take a dip here, but I think that the future does look bright.
And he's starting to pick things up here after a tough first quarter.
Atlanta's gone 5 of 8 from three-point land. 15 points and a deep ball for them tonight. Millsap left side. Back to Williams. Here's the three. And it's Randolph with the rebound.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
And finished off by Gasol.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor.
Mm-hmm. And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Horford, good.
He is just so good from that range, guys.
You know, never mind with the height advantage he had there.
Conley dishes to Allen. Pass to Gasol. And he banks in the layup. Gasol's got 8 points in the quarter.
What a job he's doing here. I mean, his second quarter has been even better than his first, and that was pretty good.
And here we go with Allen.
Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, it's startling that he'd even try that right now.
Outside Teague. Right side Millsap. Back to Teague. Bangs home the trifecta. Teague's got 7 points.
And he was one step ahead of the defense when he fired that pass for the assist.
Conley into the lane, and the layup falls. Second quarter ends in a tight one. It's Atlanta leading by a point. Folks, stay tuned for the halftime show with Damon Bruce for all the highlights from our first half.
You by Sprint.
And it's a battle underway out in Atlanta as we get going to recap the action. Atlanta with a lead against Memphis. Outstanding bench production. They've gotten a very nice lift, and that's made a huge difference for them on the scoreboard. The first half performance of Jeff Teague, just terrific. He's got 7 points, and he's stacking up the assists too, keeping the defense off balance with his passing. And for Memphis, they're looking good in their own right. And defensively, they've done a good job grabbing rebounds, limiting second chances. A sensational first half from Marc Gasol. The buckets are coming for him at a tremendous rate. He's really dialed in. And that's all we got for you here in the studio. Time to send you back out to Kevin, Steve, Clark, and Doris for the start of the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Dominance in the post by him so far, just tearing them up when he gets inside.
And getting it to him is the only hard part. Once he has it, he's automatic.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. And so in the game for the Hawks, Jeff Teague and Lou Williams, the back court with the three, with Paul Millsap at the four. And it's Horford at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
Boy, beautiful assist. That's a couple of teammates clearly on the same page.
Mike Conley, the number 4 pick back in 2007 out of the Ohio State University. He wasn't an instant star in the NBA, but boy, has he continued to improve year in and year out.
The Grizzlies trail by 3. And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Hey, guys. Well, Grizzlies head coach Dave Yeager is all in on advanced stats, and that was a big reason that he became their head coach. Fitting in with the among the lowest in 3-point field goals, in his words, look to open the floor. 9 dudes in the paint when Zach's trying to back down. But guys, they're still going to play inside out. He said, quote, I like 3-pointers, but I love layups and free throws.
Well, Doris, it makes sense. They're tough to handle down there, and it opens up things for everyone else. And Conley has played his entire career with the Memphis Grizzlies, improving alongside the team.
I feel like he's going to be an all-star before too long. He's the franchise's all-time leader in assists. But I think the stability and the faith that the organization has placed in him has helped him mature and helped him develop into
where he is right now, which I think is one of the best point guards in the game.
I would agree.
Now a timeout called by Memphis.
Well, throughout the league and its history, defense is always trapped in execution. Off.
The Grizzlies trail by three. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Yes, guys. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team. He wanted them running low at the defensive end, saying, quote, if they're going to make them make shots from the outside, those could prove.
Doris, the Grizzlies have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Well, Clark, you said defense are part of the game that never has an off night. And it's why the Grizzlies, Steve, are so tough on the road and really such a tough team in general.
Well, 24-17 on the road is an amazing record for any club. And I think Memphis, they did it with their defense and their rebounding. They were able to enforce their identity on teams on the road with that toughness, with that edge. And it really paid off big time.
And another basket for Memphis.
Right there, Randolph doing a good job opening up space for the shooter with the solid screen.
Conley against T. Rejected by Gasol. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Hawks will retain possession. So Memphis going with almost an entire new group here. Just four to shoot. And as it goes out of bounds, Atlanta able to keep the ball here. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. And that is good. And that's now 9 points for Paul Millsap.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him and he had to take it.
Outside Conley. And there's the pass to Randall. That's in there. Conley with the assist. 16 points for Zach Randolph.
8 of the last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint.
Man, it's not necessarily strategic, Clark. It's just a matter of playing with no heart. Got to play hard, guys.
Here's Carroll. He's got 6. Shot clock at 6. Here's Schroeder. Another 3 for Atlanta.
The D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. 3 of the last 5 baskets they've allowed have been of the three-point variety.
Yeah, and unless they make some rotations and closeouts defensively, there's more to come, Clark.
Here is Bayless. Out of bounds, Atlanta takes possession.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
Here's Schroeder. He's got 11. Soft touch off the glass. Schroeder's got the lead up to 8 now for the Hawks.
Good possession there, resulting in the easy one down low.
Here's Conley. And the layup's good off the glass. Conley's got 4 points this quarter.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Brand against Randolph. Millsap passes to Brand. That's good. Brand's got the lead back up to 8 now for the Hawks.
You know, you lose a player like Joe Johnson and you figure that your offense is going to suffer a bit, but the Hawks made some nice adjustments by becoming more of a ball movement and spacing team than an isolation team.
Now here is Conley. 8 points for him. Rejected by Millsap. And here's the fast break. Carroll leading the way. And that one's good.
What an outstanding pass and transition for the easy two.
The Grizzlies trail by 10. And Clark, you mentioned the passing from the Hawks. Last season, 2nd in the NBA in percentage of their possessions. With an assist, Steve, not bad.
Well, they had a pretty well-rounded roster last year, Kevin. It seemed like everybody could just come in and get double figures if they needed to. Of course, major changes in the offseason. No more Josh Smith. So they'll be relying more heavily on Al Horford, Kyle Korver, the veterans in this group.
But they're going to have to continue to work as a team to be effective offensively.
Well, he certainly isn't the one to blame for them being in the hole. He's been on the money with his game.
He kicks it to Jenkins. This one for three. Another three for Atlanta.
They are wreaking havoc on them with the three-point shot here.
Lazy perimeter defense, Clark. You got to take the shooter's airspace away from them. You know, they've been so effective when they've been able to get the ball inside.
Some real shortcomings from this defense. I mean, they've given up five straight looks in the paint.
Here's Schroeder after the made shot from Bayless. And that one's good. Millsap. Millsap's got 11 points.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
The shot and game clock separated by four, and Bayless kicks to Davis. And that one's good. He has six.
Now, he's really stood out for his club today. Even though they're struggling a little bit, he's doing his part.
Schroeder passes to Brink. Grizzlies with the rebound. Puts up a prayer. Can't get it to go. And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively as we approach the fourth quarter. Hawks lead by nine. 2K Sports back in a moment here at Phillips Arena in Atlanta. And the Grizzlies trail by nine. So on the four for Memphis. Conley and Allen are the guards. Tayshaun Prince out there with Mark Gasol. And it's Pondexter in at the three spot. Now here's Gasol. That's good. Gasol's got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Grizzlies.
Nicely done. They just continue to dominate inside. That's 10 points in a row in the lane.
It's now purely here it comes. See if you can stop it.
A shot by Williams, no good. And for Memphis, they're shooting an almost unfair 78% from the field. Allen, that's good.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
And even if it costs them some foul trouble, I mean, they need to start putting some bodies on bodies. Be physical.
Williams, that's good.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding here, piling up the assist.
Now here's Allen. From 15 feet away, rebounded by Graham.
Looked like an easy 2 points right there.
You know he's kicking himself for that miss.
Williams dishes to T. Over to the left wing. And here's Korver from the arc. And that comes off the assist by Jeff T. And now an 11-point Hawks lead. Timeout called, the Grizzlies.
A big step forward once again for Jeff Teague last season. He continued to up his scoring and assist totals.
In that break, Coach Dave Yeager had some words for his team. He led his scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
That is good. And Steve, back to Teague, he's working on that outside shooting, but as a point guard, you know, Clark, he's very effective around the rim with those little in-between shots you like so much.
Kevin, I love the arsenal he has, and every point guard needs to have those runners, floaters, flippers, I call them. You've got to have that. You're not always going to be able to get to the rim against such, you know, against bigger guys. Steve also mentioned his good free throw percentage, so the more he can get himself to the line, the better for him and his team.
Here's Gasol. Sinks that one from the post.
He's been a bright spot for them. He's had an incredibly efficient offensive performance.
Steve, his shooting really has been just terrific. They'd be much worse off if it weren't for him, that's for sure.
Now here's Teague. Now the dish to Korver. The tray. The rebound by Prince. The Grizzlies trail by nine. And here is Pondexter. Allen inside. Teague covering. And the layup's good off the glass. 12 points for Allen.
Unstoppable offense from both teams. I love the pace this game has been played at.
So does everybody else in the building. This has been a fun one.
Atlanta calls timeout.
during that break, Coach Dave Yeager had some words for his team. The one point he really drove home was that defensively, taking away the outside shot, they're going to be dedicating more man now on. So Coach waiting until the final trick's out of his sleeve. Kevin, let's see if he's made a wise decision.
And Tayshaun Prince, a low-mistake player offensively and defensively.
Yeah, he doesn't turn it over offensively. He can actually play some point forward because of his ball-handling ability. And defensively smart. He doesn't gamble. Just uses those long arms to keep you away from the hoop and challenge your shot.
He's definitely turned things around in this game. I mean, he was more of a background player in the first half. He's jumped center stage now.
And he gets it to go. 14 points for Al Horford. The Grizzlies trail by 8. Hand off, a screen on Williams. Finally into the lane. Puts it up. And the Grizzlies tack on 2 more.
Well, it's been a tale of 2 halves, hasn't it, guys? After a terrible first half, he's really picking it up.
Atlanta's gotten off 4 three-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. Here's Teague. An easy layup after coming off the pick. And the Hawks lead by 8.
But the drive to the bucket was nice, but how about the finger roll finish? Beautiful.
Conley gets to Gasol. Unloads from 13. They get it back. Randolph's shot is good.
Well, most of all, I just love the work he puts in on the offensive glass. So many of his points come on putbacks just because of sheer hustle.
You know, one other thing you have to appreciate when it comes to him is his skill on the low block. Terrific footwork, nice up and under fake, and he's got a tremendously soft touch.
The Grizzlies trail by 8. Conley with it, picked up by Teague. Conley kicks to Randall. And that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. 20 points for Zach Randolph.
He is setting this place on fire, fellas. His shooting has been off the charts.
Conley against Teague. 11 feet away, and he knocks down the jumper. Teague's got 6 in the quarter. Now a timeout called by Memphis. They're down by 8. .149 left to play here in the fourth. Outside Conley. That one's in there. The Hawks lead is cut down to just 6 points with the basket from Zach Randolph. The Hawks have gone 8 of 10 from the field here in the fourth quarter. Really getting it done. And that one's good. And that's 13 points for Paul Millsap. Memphis working against the clock now. Conley, the pass to Allen. And he gets it to go.
Well executed possession. They controlled the shot. Nicely done.
Atlanta's gotten off 4 three-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. And there's the rejection.
Time is definitely not on their side at this point.
Yeah, they need a quick bucket.
Really left alone that time. And now just a 3-point Hawks lead.
For a lazy defense, and that's why the score is what it is right now.
Time. 107 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Williams dishes to Millsap. The basket is good off the assist from Williams. And that's 15 points for Millsap.
Count how many of the possessions have ended just like that one, with him bailing them out with a big shot.
Steve, he's been fantastic, and that's the reason this game is coming down to this. I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points, not the dramatics.
Oh, come on, Clark. He had to go for it, didn't he?
I'm with you, Kevin. You can't fault him for that. Just let him go. Who cares?
A floater.
Really good awareness right there on that shot.
40 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And it's Conley penetrating. Gasol nails it. What a beautiful shot to bring him to within 3.
Boy, poor defense at both ends. It kind of reminds me of your teams, Clark.
Well, not exactly. We did give a little better effort. I mean, need the squad really giving in at that end. At least we tried to play defense.
Now a timeout called by Memphis. They're down. Here's Conley. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Allen gets to Conley. Good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Oh, what a clutch shot. That could be the difference maker.
Big, big moment in this game.
When they foul intentionally, they're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Well, you do what you have to do to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management crucial.
And they go to the intentional foul. And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall. And he ends up making the second, and that makes it a 3-point lead. There's 18 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Kicks to Gasol. Fires from 18, and he didn't get quite enough under that one.
That's a shot he's got to hit, and you don't get too many better looks from that range.
First free throw is good, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. Here's Prince. It falls. And so it's the Hawks who come out on top. It was tight, but they managed to come up with the win.
You know, nobody wants to lose a close game, Kevin. It's much better to win those tight ones.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing.